Yeah, which is the part of the arching you can see from top there, and that's the foundation surface or the natural coral rock. Downward, this is all natural coral rock, so carved. And on top here, you can see this was a room which collapsed during the war, one of the walls. And you can see there's a door on the other side here. There was a wooden floor here which fell down, and you can see some windows on this side. Okay. And here, these are two rooms to have out of a rock, and they're used to store their ammunition. So this is not clearly written, but these are two rooms to have, and they're used to store their ammunition. This is the first room, all carved out of the hard rock. This was not built, it was carved. And this is the second room. This is the second room, which was also carved. You can see a proof that this place was carved, not built. These are just holes of which maybe they are continuing in carving this hard rock. They maybe wanted maybe they wanted to add another room inside it, but due to the time, due to the war, they're not able to construct other rooms. From here, you can see that's the gates. It is part of the arches, but later British blocked it to prevent prisoners from escaping when it became a government prison. So from 1895 to 1958, under the British East African Protectorate, this was a government prison. So they had to block every gate to prevent prisoners not to escape. And on top there, on top of this house, which is the captain's house, the first captain was known as Matthias Mendes Vasconcelos, was living inside this house. And on top of this house, there was a platform there, which was known as the gun platform, where the guns were placed to shoot the ships were passing the entry to the old port of Mombasa. Pause.